two topics that often get overlooked in Australian construction are air tightness and insulation completeness. More emphasis is coming on build quality, not so much what you build with, but how well you put everything together. Most of the developed world have started to get a handle on this. They build more airtight, they inspect during construction, they then test to make sure they've ended up with a good result. In the UK, every single house has to meet a requirement for airtightness, and they test with a blower door to prove it. In most states in the US, it's the same from cold climates to mild climates and even hot climates. The more insulation used in our buildings, airtightness also becomes more important. It just makes sense. Why pay to heat and cool your home and then just let the air leak out? There's a lot of problems associated with doing that. If it leaks air, it might leak water. If it leaks air, it's going to allow bugs in. Air leakage wastes money on power bills. There's no good argument for air leakage through the building envelope itself, whether it be your floors, your walls, or your ceilings. Once you seal a building up well, you can add some effective ventilation, and then it all finally works. Build tight and ventilate right. Today we're going to do a blower door test on a typical new build with Phil Alviano from Master Builders.
Thanks, John. And I want to ask you today, when we're doing a blower door test, what does it actually help us with, or what does it tell us about a house?
We're simulating around about 32 kilometre hour winds on all the facades.
So once we've got the blower door running, we can wander through the house. Yep. We can have a look and try and find where those leaks are and those drafts.
So there are many.
And those sorts of, they're the sorts of things caused, I guess, when we're not putting an effective air barrier around the outside of the building.
When we talk about doing a blower door test to look for air leakage, what does that actually mean? I mean, if you were to combine all the leaks measured by a blower door, how big would that hole actually be? Well, let's look at the maximum air leakage allowed when you use a blower door for compliance with sealing requirements in the 2019 NCC. That's a permeability of 10 at blower door pressure. For a typical house, that level of leakiness would need a hole the same size as a standard window open by around about 200 to 300 mil. That's a pretty large hole to have permanently open in your building during hot or cold weather. Spread over a whole house, it's about the same size as having a dollar coin sized hole in every square meter. That wastes a lot of heating and cooling energy, making your energy bills larger and the people living in the home uncomfortable.
When you're trying to build tighter, you've got two kinds of leaks to deal with. The big ones, which are usually individual ones. Those are like a leaky manhole hatch, holes behind cabinetry, or even a door with a poor seal. Then you have little ones, lots of little holes that are spread all over your house. They require different approaches. Take an obvious one, your front door or your internal door to your garage, which usually has no door seal installed. That lets in hot or cold air depending on the season, as well as odors. Bugs can also come in from this point as well. Taking care of these is as straightforward as getting a weather seal kit for your doors. This one should be obvious too. Bathroom fans should have a draft stopper on them to seal them shut when they're not in use. In fact, it's required by code now. When the fan isn't running, it shouldn't be leaking air out of your house. A good bathroom fan, like this one, will have an integrated draft stopper that stays shut when the fan is not running. You can also buy them separately to retrofit an existing exhaust fan. The roof manhole without a seal, this thing lights up with air leakage on infrared thermal imaging during an air tightness test. It also usually doesn't have insulation installed above it, but it's so easy to fix. Some compressible foam seals will make this into a non-issue. Just put the seal around the opening and the cover will rest on it, providing a good seal. As we walk around a home, some of these leaks can seem to repeat over and over. One really annoying one is downlights. Make sure you buy a light fitting that is rated for insulation to be in contact. They're usually sealed tight for air leakage and insulated. Older lights or ones that aren't insulation contact or IC rated can use something like this downlight cover. It's fireproof, makes a good seal, and even provides some insulation value. There are many things that can be done to improve the performance of homes, and blower door testing can help people understand where air leakage is contributing to a poorer performing building envelope. Air tightness testing is coming to Australia eventually. Let's get ahead of the game. The future of residential building in Australia will be strongly influenced by consumer demand for energy efficiency, comfort, climate resilience, and quality. Both the Building Codes Board and Australian governments are committed to the COAG trajectory for low energy buildings, and this will affect building regulations, including the NCC. Builders will be expected to place increased emphasis on meeting and proving energy efficiency compliance. You'll be asked more and more to understand and deliver both code compliance and long-term building health and performance. You will need to build tight and ventilate right.